Ken Dooley has been named as the man who died after an incident at Kempton Racecourse on Saturday night. Dooley, a long-serving member of stable staff, is believed to have been kicked by a horse. The cause of his death is now the subject of a police investigation. Dooley was named by his employer, the Sussex-based trainer Amanda Parrott, in a statement issued through the Racing Post. She said, "It is with huge sadness that I can confirm we lost our friend and colleague Ken Dooley after an incident in the stable yard at Kempton last night. Ken had been with us for 7 years and was a very special member of our family business at Cumlins. He was an excellent employee, very experienced with racehorses, having worked all of his life with them as a jockey, trainer and jockey coach around the world. He was always first into work in the morning, hugely enthusiastic and dedicated to his horses and a very much valued and integral member of our team." U.S. Navy flag leads home Aiden O'Brien 1-2-3-4 in Dewhurst Stakes. Read more. "I would like to thank my staff, the stable and racecourse staff at Kempton, Hugo Palmer's traveling head lad, Dr. Lucy Free and the ambulance service who were so quickly there to help Ken. Our thoughts are with his family at this very sad time." A spokesman for Surrey Police said that officers were called to Kempton following a report of a sudden death around 9:20 p.m. on Saturday, the 14th of October. A man in his 50s was sadly pronounced dead at the scene. The death is currently being treated as unexplained and inquiries remain ongoing. The jockey Martin Dwyer, who was riding at Kempton on Saturday, said on Racing UK, "There was a very somber mood and nobody really knew what was going on. And then we found out, as I was leaving, there were blue lights everywhere and it was a bit of a shock. It highlights what a dangerous sport this is and makes you think of the stupid things we worry about. Making the weight, will I ride this horse or that? Then something like this happens and the whole industry takes a breath. Unfortunately, horses do kick out and I believe that's what happened. They have metal shoes on and if you get a kick from a horse, it can be very serious. Horses don't mean to do it. If they feel frightened or threatened, if they feel someone is too close or something, they do kick out, but fortunately it is very rare. It is very sad." Racing Welfare, a charity that supports the workforce of British horse racing, tweeted, "Our thoughts are with everyone affected by the incident," and published a helpline number for staff in need of support. The Newmarket trainer Eb Dunlop wrote on his website, "Horses are beautiful animals but they can also be incredibly dangerous and it was terrible to hear of the tragedy at Kempton Park last night. Everyone in the racing community is thinking of everyone closely involved and it is extremely sad that someone dedicated to our sport has lost their life in such tragic circumstances. Black armbands will be worn by staff and jockeys at race meetings at Chepstow and Goodwood on Sunday." A statement from the Racecourse Association said, "We are deeply saddened by the tragic news from Kempton Park last night and would like to express sincere condolences on behalf of all racecourses to the family, friends and colleagues of the individual who lost his life. Racecourses do everything they can to provide a safe working environment in all areas and are equipped to provide the highest level of medical care and attention whenever it is required. This tragic accident is a reminder of the dangerous nature of the work stable staff do day in, day out, and our thoughts are very much with everybody affected at this difficult time." The National Trainers Federation also expressed its sadness and added, "Mercifully, fatal accidents in the course of caring for racehorses in Britain are rare and we acknowledge and salute the commitment of stable employees across the country who devote their working lives to their horses." The Kempton stewards reported on Saturday night that a serious incident had occurred in the stable area before the penultimate race at 8:45 p.m. All medical personnel on the site were immediately directed to the scene, meaning that the track was no longer medically compliant to continue racing. In the stewards' words, which was the immediate cause of the abandonment,